Now let's take a look at the tools and materials you'll need to build your VersaLock wall. To start with, you'll need a sufficient number of VersaLock units, VersaTough pins, and cap units. Your VersaLock design and installation guide has everything you need to estimate and specify your materials. The VersaLifter is a tool designed specifically for VersaLock standard that makes it easier to lift and place units, especially on the base course. You'll need a 4-foot level to keep your units level lengthwise, and a smaller torpedo level like this one is helpful to keep them level front to back. A string line stretched behind your wall is also helpful in maintaining a straight wall. A finishing trowel will help get a smooth, even layer of sand on top of your leveling pad. You'll also need a shovel, tape measure, broom, some good gloves, and ear and eye protection. Steel-toed boots aren't a bad idea either when you're working with concrete. Although a hand tamper may be sufficient for compacting small jobs, a vibratory plate compactor will ensure that your crushed rock leveling pad, drainage aggregate, and backfill are compacted thoroughly and evenly. That's important if you want a level wall that will perform properly. A large mallet is good to use for tapping units into place. A brick hammer can be used to modify the texture and also to set your pins. For splitting units while maintaining a split face texture, such as for corners, you'll need a masonry chisel and a 4-pound sledgehammer. If you're going to be doing a lot of splitting, you might consider renting a mechanical splitter. If you're going to be cutting any VersaLock units where you need a smooth edge for tight-fitting joints, you should rent a gas-powered concrete cutoff saw with a diamond blade. You can also use a standard circular saw equipped with a masonry or diamond blade. For your leveling pad, you'll need crushed rock base material like this, typically the same material that's used for road base aggregate. This gets topped with a layer of sand. For drainage behind your wall, you'll need 3/4-inch clear, free-draining angular aggregate. Be sure it's free of fine particles, so it provides proper drainage even after compacting. You'll also need a supply of clean soil for backfill. You may already have that available on site or left over from your excavation. Otherwise, you'll need to have some delivered. Depending on the height of your wall, you may need a perforated minimum 4-inch diameter drain pipe to collect water along the base of the drainage aggregate and quickly move it away from the wall. You'll need some VersaLock concrete adhesive and a caulking gun to bond your cap units to the top of the wall and also for bonding partial units where pinning is impossible. You may need some VersaGrid GeoGrid soil reinforcement, a utility knife, and some stakes, depending on how much your wall needs to support.